I'm Nikki Phillips. I'm the current training program director in the East Midlands region. I also work as a consultant psychodynamic psychotherapist. As you can see from some of our lovely pictures in the background, the East Midlands region is a great place to live as well as to work. However, today on this video, our focus is going to be on training experiences for trainees in the region in medical psychotherapy. So first off, I'd like to introduce you to Yamini.
Hello.
So Yamini, would you like to tell us about a bit about yourself?
Yes, thank you, Harula. I'm doing a dual training. I'm based in Leicester and I specialize in psychodynamic psychotherapy.
Okay, so just to say, I'm your trainer, Harula Constantinidou, I'm a consultant medical psychotherapist in Leicester. So Yamini, why medical psychotherapy then?
Oh, I think for me, even as a psychiatrist, I've always been drawn to the patient's life story, their narratives, and to understand their meaning and how it links to the presenting problems. So choosing psychotherapy was an obvious choice for me. I think every patient has a unique story to tell. I feel it's a privilege to listen to their experiences, and it's immensely satisfying to help them understand themselves. And I also like the fact that in psychotherapy, we help patients with a wide range of emotional problems across various psychiatric disorders and some with medical symptoms. And something I particularly enjoy in psychotherapy is the blend of art and science, because there is the scientific theory and knowledge, but equally important is also how we get creative, how we use our imagination to understand what the patient brings. And underlying all this is what is central is the therapeutic relationship. How the patient relates to us is a major part of the treatment itself. So for me, that's very special. And I feel it's very rewarding to be part of the patient's journey in their towards their recovery.
Thank you, Yamini. So could you tell us a little bit about the structure of your training in Leicester?
The structure itself is a sequential model because I'm a dual trainee. The first 2 years I spent more time in adult psychiatry, 4 days to be precise, and 1 day in medical psychotherapy. And the next 2 years was predominantly medical psychotherapy. And right now I'm in my final year. It's more of an integrated post.
Mm-hmm. And a little bit about the clinical opportunities you've had over these years.
I think I had a wide range of clinical experiences within psychotherapy. As I said, I specialize in psychodynamic therapy, but I also train in other specialties like CBT, family therapy, modified analytic work like group analysis, MBT, and DIT. And what I'm pleased is with the quality of supervision I receive in all the other psychotherapy that I've been training in, because every supervisor I have, they are experienced and specialized in the particular therapy, and I feel that really makes a difference. It helps me consolidate the differences and the similarities in the various models.
Okay, thanks, Yamini. So a wide range of opportunities in Leicester. So Yamini, would you like to introduce us to the next trainee?
Yes, Ian is also training in Leicester in CBT. So over to you, Ian.
Hi, yeah, thank you, Yamini. Thank you, Hula. Yeah, my name is Ian Chamberlain. I'm an ST6, also in Leicester Partnership Trust. I'm also dual training, but my specialty within medical psychotherapy is CBT. And the structure of that is very similar to that which you described, Yamini, in terms of the slant towards general adult was in the ST4 year with a day per week in CBT. And then switching the other way around for ST5 and 6. Likewise, while my predominant training has been within CBT, which sits in Leicester with a dedicated centralised CBT team at this time, there's also the opportunity there, which is on the go at the moment for dynamic cases, and there's some upcoming systemic family work all based within the trust. And I'd echo the comments about supervision. Supervisors very available. To sit within a centralised team is something I think is very valuable and not something that necessarily all trainees get with the march towards decentralisation. But the team here I found to be very coherent, very available, approachable, and certainly the expertise really, I think, is sort of second to none, actually. Within the general adult side, LPT will provide the full range, really, of the clinical opportunities. And my first job was on a general adult ward with a community team post as well. And then as it's gone to one day a week, there are a variety of specialty posts which enhance the general adult side of things, such as ASD, ADHD, and I'm able to move within the whole region, and I'm now occupying a day a week in the gender service in Nottingham, which is fantastically interesting as well.
Thank you, Ian. That's fantastic, Ian. Just to introduce myself, I'm Bina. I'm a consultant psychiatrist and psychotherapist from Lincolnshire. Ian, that sounds very interesting. There's a breadth and a width to your training. I was just wondering about what drew you to psychotherapy. When did you decide that you wanted to do your ST training in psychotherapy and especially in CBT? So what drew you to psychotherapy?
Sure. Yeah, of course. And I would say that my core training was done within the East Midlands school as a whole, predominantly in the north side up in Nottingham and over in Lincoln. And I think probably from the word go, when I was thinking about psychiatry specialty training, I was very keen. I was holding in mind the psychotherapeutic dimension. And I've heard it said that, you know, anything that we can do with patients, which is around mental health, emotional well-being, with a loose sense can be thought of as a psychotherapeutic opportunity. But I think that to incorporate that in a formal sense within a psychiatric training is incredibly valuable, but not just in the sense of having skills to treat patients one-to-one or group with a particular modality, but also about what it can teach us and what we can benefit from in terms of our professional interactions. Dynamic therapy and CBT, I think, have something to offer in terms of understanding how we interact within teams and in with our colleagues as well as our patients as well. CBT, I think the interest there derives from my core training experiences, some of which were over in Lincoln, and I think the emphasis being on the availability of that, the availability of enthusiastic supervisors and trainers, and a culture with which that is sort of actively promoted, made it not just a kind of pipe dream, it made it available, really. And so there wasn't really all that much question of not incorporating it. I think even if it's not a question of practicing directly, I think our psychiatry practice has so much to benefit from a psychotherapeutic training as well.
Ian, just one last question, Ian. In dual training, you're required to train as a psychiatrist and as a psychotherapist. How does both sit together, and do you find that challenging? Because the skill set, whilst there are lots of commonalities, there are some differences as a psychiatrist and as a psychotherapist. How does that affect your training? What does it take from you in terms of, you know, as a person in your training?
I think during the earlier days of my higher training, I think what it required was a certain amount of mental leap. And I was finding when approaching CBT, my earlier cases, even in the formulation stage, I was finding myself drawn towards a kind of psychiatric history taking and thinking in ways that attach conventionally to psychiatry. I think what's made it possible to integrate that is actually a largely to do with the quality of supervision, in a sense, and just getting used to having almost a dual framework within the mind as well. You know, what is it that we're dealing with here? What is the, you know, we can all think that we're dealing with emotional distress, but whether we call it a mental illness or not is another matter. I think sometimes the trick has been to not try and introduce too much of the psychotherapeutic frame into a general adult outpatient clinic, because remaining clear about our patients' needs from us at that time, I think, is probably quite crucial. But while it's been a learning curve, I think it's something that's very possible to develop. I'm enjoying it.
Thank you, Ian. Now over to Murat and Nikki.
Thanks, Bina. So, Murat, we know each other well, and you're based in Nottingham in the North School. Perhaps you could tell us a bit about why you decided to do higher training in medical psychotherapy.
Well, I think it was mostly my core training, which was quite a long time ago. We used to call people SHOs in those days, and this was in London. And during my core training, I had experiences when I was seeing my long cases, when my when I would present back to my tutor, and they would pick out things that the patient had said and interpret the underlying meaning behind what was being said. And I was quite astonished. It was almost like Sherlock Holmes would pick out one tiny little detail and build something on it. So I felt as if I'd been missing half of what's being said by not listening carefully enough to what people are saying between the lines. So that was a very powerful experience for me. Then I did staff grade psychiatry for 10 years after my membership. And eventually I just wanted to have a bit more psychological depth to the understanding of my patients, especially the ones that have got complex trauma or attachment needs difficulties early on, which I think in the general psychiatric frame are difficult to conceptualize and formulate and harder to help. So that was one of the key areas that I wanted to learn a bit more about.
Thanks, Murat. And I'm aware we haven't got too much longer on the video, so if you could just give us the highlights of the clinical opportunities you've managed to have in Nottingham and in the North.
Okay, well, a lot of it's like Yamini, because I'm on the psychodynamic psychotherapy course rather than CBT. And as mentioned, that the structure is the first 2 years you do mostly general adult, and then you do mostly psychotherapy for the second 2 years, and then it's integrated in the final one. The opportunities that I've enjoyed have been teaching, especially. So you get sent medical students, you get sent membership students, and also supervising other trainees. You can learn a great deal by supervising others. So the teaching opportunities I've enjoyed. I think Ian's mentioned the gender clinic in Nottingham, which is nationally known and referred to. And they're very open to higher trainees coming and spending 1 day a week or whatever, just to sort of really get an insight into something that's very fresh and new in society, and to think about that in a dynamic way. So that's a huge opportunity. Our early intervention service is also a great opportunity. And in terms of the psychotherapy, up in Millbrook, we have a person who works at Gestalt, and we have another therapist who works in the transactional analysis. So I've had the opportunity to work with psychodynamic professionals of different leanings and integrate that. So that, I think that's been a big opportunity for me as well.
And I think you've also spent some time at the eating disorders service as well, haven't you, trying to integrate both aspects of your training?
Yeah, that's been one of the most rewarding parts of the training, in that you have a fresh look at psychiatric conditions, but now you're looking at it from a dynamic point of view and trying to understand how the sort of unconscious processes are affecting the presentation. So it's a very different sort of way of looking at things than general psychiatry.
Thanks, Murat. I'm aware we haven't got too much longer. I believe we're now over to the trainees to just mention something briefly, perhaps, about teaching, leadership and research.
Yes. Ian, you've been quite involved in quite a lot of work in leadership and management, haven't you? Would you like to go over some of that?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I think it probably attaches in some ways during our core training and specialty training to the category of things that can be a little bit maligned and thought of as requirements rather than sort of embedded into our experience. And I think that while we have to account for that portfolio sense and things like that, I think that my experience core and specialty training in the region has been that they don't have to come in a very formalized capacity. East Midlands region have promoted and delivered very, very good formal leadership and management courses, which I have benefited from. But my experience from the general adult side and the medical psychotherapy side has been to be involved, to be privy to opportunities, decisions, meetings, which actually show what it is like to occupy the later consultant roles, to think about service, things like service development, to think how leadership acts even at a very local level with our colleagues and our teams. So I think that there's it's not something that is specific to training in psychiatry or psychotherapy. We're not exempt or immune from that kind of thing. But I think far from just accepting it, it's very embraced really within this region, and we can gain a lot of skills through this training. That's been my personal experience. Yeah. Yeah. And that, I guess, I mean, we're thinking of things like that, that maybe we can think of as the periphery of things. But my experience of sort of the research side of things has also been quite positive. I don't know about you, Murat. Have you experienced?
Yeah. Thank you, Ian. I mean, when it comes to research, I think Nottinghamshire, the deanery recognises that it's quite hard to get a research project up and going on your own. So they do give a lot of help. The Institute of Mental Health is based in Nottingham, and we're always very well, you know, always very welcome there. The other things that I found interesting, for example, my own research project, I've been supported in coming up with my own idea. And what I did was I set up a group with the crisis team, one of the crisis teams, and I used a weekly supervision group to both convey psychodynamic ideas and to case supervise, with the view to seeing if that would change the practices of the crisis team when it comes to dealing with the attachment trauma and complex trauma. So that's been some research that I've enjoyed doing as well. And of course, we have the Wednesday academic meetings when a paper is always presented, which is traditional, I'm sure, around the country. And then, of course, there's Dr. Lancaper, who does the magnetic, the big brain magnet, as I call it, to fix depression. So he's always looking for higher trainees to get involved in that. So I think the research opportunities are quite good in Nottingham. And the most important thing is that you get help in getting through the process. So they have people that can help with the ethics committee write up and all of that stuff, which, you know, can be quite a mountain of paperwork.
Thanks very much, Murat. I know that Yaman has had to leave because she actually has a job interview, so that's quite important, so she sends her apologies. But I think perhaps this final section of the video could be about us as a group of consultants saying something about what it is we're looking for in a higher trainee in medical psychotherapy. Harula, I don't know if you've got any thoughts, and Beena as well.
I think our trainees have more or less demonstrated, they embodied what we're looking for. A lot of trainees who go into psychiatry, actually, they expect to do more psychotherapy than they do. So we're looking for curiosity into human nature. We're looking for the capacity to stay with not knowing, uncertainty, a drive to learn, and a commitment. And I just wanted to say, when I say commitment, we also encourage less than full-time training for people who have families and they worry that it's too much of a commitment. Because it's a developmental journey and they can do it over a longer period of time. So that's from me.
I think I just want to echo what Harula said and what our trainees have said. There are two things that we look for. One is the innate aspect, because this the therapeutic relationship as psychotherapists with our patients is quite different. They perhaps open up and talk about stuff that they've never spoken to anybody else. So it's a real privilege. And I think a trainee needs to have that innate sense of humanity and warmth. So that's the innate aspect, and curiosity and unconditional warmth. I think that's important. The other aspect is perhaps acquired and developmental, not just as a trainee, but throughout one's career. And that's the aspect of, I suppose, the yin-yang aspects of being non-defensive, being able to tune into someone with a deep sense of receptiveness and responsiveness, and whilst holding on to a sense of robustness, to be able to hold the boundaries, to be willing to challenge the status quo sometimes. And I suppose to have that sense of robustness. And I think so those two aspects are developmental. So that's what we look for in our trainees.
Great, thanks very much. Well, I don't think I need to add anything more to what you've both said. So I'd like to bring this to a close now, really, and say goodbye to whoever's watching this. I hope we've enabled you to be curious about higher training in medical psychotherapy and stimulated your interest. And hopefully we'll see some of you at some point in the future. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.